The great thing about the United Kingdom is that entrepreneurship and business is quite a norm in the UK. It's very liberal. We have a strong legal system. We have the ability to create a registered company within a few minutes. And our tax is relatively low. So from an overall macro level, from an easy ecosystem level, it's very easy to start a business. Of course, there are challenges like in any organization, but we're connected, for now at least, with the European Union. We have great trade links with America, and we are increasingly more global all the time. So the National Association of College University Entrepreneurs, or NACUE, we have a simple mission, which is to power the enterprising generation. We do that for three different ways. One is that we build a grassroots community of young people who want to do businesses, and we call them enterprise societies. Second is we connect these societies together through our events program, such as our conferences, our pitches, our leader summits, and we connect them together through our online platform. And finally, we advocate. I go around UK and beyond, and I tell very experienced business people and politicians how important it is for young people to be excited in business, excited in enterprise, and make them the creators of jobs for the future. So I think there's a lot of great things happening within the skills sector of the UK in terms of young people. For one thing, we have a robust education system all the way from primary school to universities. And indeed, we have some of the world's best universities around anywhere we can see. And the range of expertise within that network is really impressive, all the way from science to technology. Of course, there's more to do. Just like in every well-developed nation, we sometimes risk having an education system that defines us in boxes. And I guess the challenge we have is to tell young people to be creative, to not be defined by a grade, not be defined by just tick-boxing your way through to a successful enterprise. Because in the real world, entrepreneurship is about imagination and being clever enough to find different ways around a system. We create fundamentally good young people, but we just have to add a little bit more spark, and it's up to us to do that. Definitely. I've got two specific examples I'd like to highlight. One is that NACUE has been working with the European Commission in a consortium of 10 partners called the My Way program. And we've been doing that for over the last year. I'm going to continue till the end of 2016. And what that involves is getting a whole bunch of amazing organizations to create a plan on how to get more young people to be tech entrepreneurs across Europe. That means doing case studies, that means liaising with universities, and creating a really good best practice guide. I'm very proud of that. The second example is something that the government's been working on and that we hope to be involved in as well, and that's called the UKTI Sirius program. It's an enterprise program where we go around the world and we find the most talented young student entrepreneur, and we bring them to the UK, and we give them all the support they need, such as money to survive, office space, technologies, mentors, everything you need to really create your business and turn it into something scalable. And in return, the UK gets more talent. We get amazing businesses. We get jobs. We get investment. And they even get a visa too. So it's a really great program. I really hope that continues. So to me, imagine enterprise being a steam engine, right? You are here to power the economy, but you can't power anything unless you have the coal, unless you have the raw materials that make the engine move. And so the first thing you need is a lot of talent, and you need a lot of young people who are willing to go out there and make things happen. And so we create this network, this enterprise society network. That is key to making an enterprise thrive. Once you've got that, what you need is to make sure that you give young people, or anyone in fact, big enough problems to solve. We don't want young people to restrict themselves in specific sectors. We want them to go and solve the biggest challenges we face, whether it's global warming or hunger. And I promise you that I think there is a moment in time where, with the combination of cheap technology, ways to go into market quickly, either because domains can be made just like that, whether it's because you use 3D printing to create a prototype within a few minutes, these possibilities has meant it's never been a better time to create a startup. So I think there's a lot of hope out there, but we need to give people more opportunities, and I think in time we'll get there.